Previously. Hi, everybody. Make sure you've watched the previous episodes to be aware of the plot. I'm Anna, and today is my sweetest day, my revenge day. As you may know, I became the Winter Queen, and I think I discovered the way to teach my beloved one, but it was too early for me to relax. Even though the smell of victory was making my head spin, there was a beautiful, elegant revenge awaiting all the traitors. I went back to the gym and whispered to everyone interested that the party at the club would start in an hour. My allies passed this information on to everyone else involved, and the crowd started to slowly disappear. The principal noticed this and announced the end of the official part. Now the students could stay for a couple of hours and have fun. All the teachers and parents went to the club. My revenge was simple. Those who have ever appeared at my parties knew very well that this was a great chance. I never let in losers, suckers, or anyone who wasn't cool enough. In fact, these parties were the school's elite club, so it was a matter of honor to be invited to any of my parties. But this time, I invited everyone. However, not everyone will get inside. I gave the security guards at the entrance the black list of people. They should deploy at the entrance hall, but not let them in the main hall. I added my ex-friends and Chad and his friends. I wanted to humiliate and trample them in public. I even brought a camera with me, and I quietly snapped their awesome faces when security let all the cool guys in and didn't let in the blacklisters. The girls poked at the guards with the invitations, tried to prove something, and weren't just going to leave in peace. Chad even tried to knock out one of the security guards, but it was for nothing. Dad doesn't keep weaklings. And instead of a beautiful blow, Chad plowed through the ground with his nose bleeding. By the way, no one touched him. A security guard just smartly stepped aside, and then gravity did everything. But all the chosen ones watched this beautiful show from the balcony and had a lot of fun. Chad's failure, and how Mickey and Lara tried to prove they had a right to be inside the club, not outside. By the way, in addition to this beautiful trio, there were some other guys who used to enter the club, but later betrayed me and laughed in my face. That's how I beautifully resolved everything. The club has officially lost a dozen of its members. My abusers were publicly shamed, and everyone else realized if they didn't want to lose their privileges, they should listen to only me and fully obey. The party went great. We danced, had fun, and did all the things teenagers usually do when their parents aren't watching them. Everyone was very pleased that my dad even hired a popular music band to play as a reward for my triumph. When I was going out, I thanked all the members of my elite club once again, and I handed them the ready-made photos with the faces of Mickey, Lara, and Chad when the security guards were putting them away, both for fun and for a reminder. For those who wanted to turn against me and repeat their fate, I fell asleep in my luxurious bed, thinking life is a beautiful thing. Next morning, I realized the black stripe is still going on. It's like a swing. It gives hope, and then it hits my face on the floor, because a new girl suddenly came to our school. And not just some ordinary newbie. She was someone who could cause me a lot of problems in the future. Her name was Ariel. Yeah, like that stupid mermaid. She had long blonde hair, full lips like from a comic book, a squeaky voice, and the latest model Jaguar, and all other attributes of a fancy life. A fashion house, expensive gadgets, stylish wear, beautiful makeup, and so on. Anyway, she was kinda a better version of me. Of course, I immediately spread a rumor. Our new girl went through too many plastic surgeries. Her gorgeous breasts weren't hers, like her lips, and too perfect ass. Maybe it wasn't even gossip, because my mom thought the same, and she'd been operated on in the best plastic surgery clinics in the city. She knows exactly about it. But it wasn't just about her appearance. The newbie was just nice, as if no one had ever taught her how to behave with people having a certain status. She spoke calmly to everyone and even, oh my god, smiled at all these sycophants and simpletons. I tried to show her who the leader of the class was, but all I got was a flutter of eyelash extensions and a polite look of bewilderment. Then our Ariel left somewhere holding hands with my ex-girlfriends. They also managed to whisper something to her, glancing at me. I didn't like it at all. I felt okay for that girl, but I don't know why, but I felt threatened by her. Seemed like this nice chameleon is actually poisonous and can attack the victim herself, and I didn't want to be a victim. But the new girl tried not to show off. She didn't interfere in the school affairs. She didn't even apply to the place of the cheerleading team captain, though she performed perfectly at the introductory training. So I relaxed. Yeah, she was rich and beautiful, but if she didn't bother me, though she shouldn't, because the elite should stick together. So I let her live. But a month later, there were only 15 people left at my private party, although the whole club was usually packed. To my question, where was everyone? And if they were too brave, I was told Arielle was now throwing a 2-day party on her dad's yacht. Like, it's her birthday and she invited the whole school. That was the first alarm bell. I explained to all the club members that it was impossible to do this. They seemed to understand it, but slowly, one by one, my people started to go to the newbie, and she didn't seem to do anything to destroy me. She just smiled at me sweetly, helped everyone, let everyone into her company. Anyway, she behaved abominably. And soon, I was alone. Ariel flirted with Chad, and he was ready to carry her in his arms. Though gossips told me they didn't have anything yet. They didn't even kiss. Ariel became the teacher's pet, because she also managed to study perfectly. Ariel was 100% nice, and she massively attracted people. They were afraid of my revenge and quickly going to her. The worst thing was that she dared to offer her friendship to me. Me, as if I needed her friendship. This was ridiculous. I wanted to destroy her, not walk around holding hands stupidly smiling. But the worst thing happened when I sat down next to Dora. Just out of habit, it was the next lab session. I thought about this quiet girl in the lab only, so I didn't really keep track of what was going on with her. But even she managed to surprise me. First, her awful sweater was gone. The loser dressed up, and even put on some makeup. Then she dared to smile at me. I was still hating her, especially after ruining my expensive Winter Queen dress. In fact, I haven't really seen her since, so why should I ever look at her? Second, after her smile, Dora said that the seat next to her was occupied. Occupied? You're serious? How is that even possible? Who would ever want to sit with stinky loser? I shouldn't have asked her all this, because I absolutely didn't like the answer. It turned out, Ariel asked to sit next to Dora. She had some special chemistry program, and only Dora could be paired with her because of her brains and knowledge. And she asked the teacher to put them together to make it easier. Of course, Dora agreed because grades are at stake. It was painful. Seriously. My heart was pounding. No, I didn't really care about Dora and her obsession with grades. But with this fact, even such a loser left me. After school, Ariel came up to me and politely tried to apologize. Apparently, she read on my face it was somehow painful to me. And she said she really needed Dora's help for chemistry, as if I wasn't humiliated enough. She was squeaking something in a low voice, talking about the importance of grades for her and her future career, projects, and some other smart garbage. But all I heard was, "You're abandoned. No one needs you anymore." Even this queen of losers and the victim of bullying chose Ariel. I don't know how I ever had the strength to just turn around and walk away. The only thing that pleased me? This time, my parents didn't interfere. They really didn't care as long as I didn't drop my reputation, and I didn't disgrace our glorious family name. And what I have in my heart was a psychologist or a diary problem, though my mom hinted it would be nice to make friends with this new girl, because her parents are some very influential people. Make friends? I couldn't even look at her without wanting to pull her hair out. She had humiliated me, and I was actually almost on my knees in front of her. My friends went to her, and I saw they didn't pretend. They really liked her. My loyal minions chatted about her in the hallways, admiring and almost preying on her Instagram. Only, Dora was there too. She would shadow me and try to look me in the eye, and it was, well, nice, I guess. But even she was still sitting with Ariel in class and smiling at her. For some reason, the image of two heads, Dora and Ariel, leaning over the same textbook made me mad. I got crazy even more when I saw Ariel and Chad together. I still liked him, even though he was such a freak. I wanted to scream and break everything around me and demand that Dora, with her puppy dog look, immediately get away from this self-assured newbie and come back to me. Of course, it was all about the grades, what else? Without Dora, my chemistry knowledge left much to be desired. From time to time, I watched Dora smiling at Ariel and imagined myself in her place. It was very painful and somehow offensive. The only way I could get rid of the new girl once and for all was to set a trap for her. And this should be such a trap. No one else would ever want to talk to Ariel, especially Dora, whispered my sarcastic inner voice. But I silenced it with thoughts there was no time for such stupidity. Judging by the new girl's popularity, I might have missed out on the school's prom crown, and that was more important for me than any inner voice. Fortunately, I had my genius brain with me. I was the cheerleading team captain, and I could enter the women's locker room at any time. Did you like the story? Write in the comments. What do you think will happen next? Subscribe to the channel and click the bell button not to miss the next episode. See you later, guys!